Hello, I'm Joel Dehring with the International Volleyball Hall of Fame. We are speaking one-on-one today with members of the induction class for 2018. This is Volleyball in Perspective. I'm joined by Evgenia Artemanova Estes of Russia, who will be speaking to us with the assistance of her husband, Jerry Estes. Evgenia, welcome to you and your son, Jaron. You are being inducted for your career as one of the world's best, along with your distinction as the only female indoor player to compete in six consecutive Olympic Games. You started your international playing career early at the age of 16, contributing to your 1991 team's bronze medal at the FIVB World Cup. You trained under Hall of Fame coach Nikolai Karpol and won a silver medal in the 1992 Barcelona Games, your first of six straight Olympic experiences. You added two more silver medals along the way and played in 35 Olympic game matches. You were part of three gold medal World Grand Prix teams in 1997, 1999, and 2002. Collected three bronze medals at the FIVB World Championships, and you also led your team to four European Championships. You then turned to the professional volleyball circuit and won championships for five different countries during that time, and your Russian club team also won 10 national championships. You married Jerry, who served as an assistant coach for the Long Beach State 1994 national championship team and with both the USA and Russian national women's programs. Together, you established a volleyball factory in the Los Angeles area, contributing to the development of juniors in that area. Finally, back in your home country, you were honored with two prestigious awards, the Commander of the Order of Friendship and Honored Master of Sports. Tell us first how you became involved in volleyball.
Как вы начали играть в волейбол?
Мама привела меня в школу 7 лет, и так началась моя карьера.
At 7 years old, my mother took me to volleyball school and volleyball.
And did you play other sports as a youngster, or did you go to volleyball and stay in that one sport?
Только для здоровья плаванием и фигурным катанием.
She swam and she was a figure skater, but it was general for general health.
In those early years, was there a particular coach who had the greatest influence on you when you first started playing and learning the game?
Когда вы первый начали, какой тренер был самый импактивный на вашей жизни?
Наш молодой тренер Юрий Николаевич Филимонов, мой первый тренер.
Юрий Николаевич Филимонович was
талантливый человек.
He was her coach when she first started, and he was a very talented coach.
Который заложил базу для моей дальнейшей карьеры.
He helped build the base of her career.
You're part of an amazing legacy of female inductees to the International Volleyball Hall of Fame from both the former Soviet Union and Russia. Did you have a sports hero when you were growing up?
Я об этом не думала.
She never really thought about it. Mm.
So what were the biggest challenges for you when you joined the national team at the age of 16?
Я была тогда слишком молодая, чтобы что-то понимать, но, конечно, для меня была Олимпиада. Я старалась.
She was extremely young to understand the entire situation.
Попасть на Олимпиаду, но когда мне сказали, что я еду, для меня это было, может, как что?
But she knew that she wanted to go to the Olympics. She didn't think that she was really going to make the team. Mm. But she always thought about it ahead of her. And then when she was announced to be on the team, she was very happy and shocked.
Я просто не поняла, что мой тренер в таком молодом возрасте в меня поверил, что я достаточно хорошо играю, чтобы поехать на Олимпиаду.
At that age, she was surprised that her coach trusted her enough at that age to select her and put her on the team to perform.
So, on those earliest teams, did you have one or two teammates who had the greatest impact on you?
Какие команды?
Но когда в начале, это первая несколько команда, которую ты начал, 16 лет, какие игроки старше который помогал, или ты запоминаешь, как они
тебя
держали?
Я думаю, что все игроки очень помогали, потому что понимали, что для меня это большая нагрузка.
All of the players.
Каждый старался внести какую-то помощь.
To take a little bit responsibility of educating her, because they understood that the workload and the responsibility was very big for someone who was that age.
Потому что они были достаточно старше на 10 лет.
And they were old enough to not be so much threatened by her, that they knew they were all 10 years older than her. Mm-hmm. So they understood that their job was to raise her.
I know eventually you served as captain a lot, but at what point did you see yourself as a leader?
Ну, также поддержать, наверное, игроков.
Нет.
Помочь.
Вопрос такой, когда ты стал капитан, это понятно. Mm-hmm. Но когда ты сама верила и чувствовала, ты был лидер команды.
Ой. Mm-hmm. Я думаю, что с самого детства, но как бы тренера как контролировали этот момент, чтобы не дать мне, как сказать, может...
She thinks she felt that from a very young age, but the coaches didn't allow her to be free. They kind of contained her.
Потому что они боялись, что я могу слишком как зазвездиться, есть такое слово, я не знаю, как сказать.
They knew that her ability could kind of get out of control, mm-hmm. and they would lose control of her, so mm-hmm. they kept it at a level mm-hmm. that was maintainable.
So 6 Olympic games in a row. You're the only female indoor volleyball player to ever accomplish that feat. I have 2 questions for you. Either order. As it relates to the Olympic Games, all those games, was there a particularly disappointing moment, and was there a most memorable moment?
Самый высокий момент и самый низкий момент — это 6 Олимпийские игр для тебя.
Ну, поражение — это самое низкое, наверное.
The losses are the lowest.
Потому что нас воспитывали только на первое место считается для нашей команды хорошее.
We were taught that only first place.
Только это поражение. Поэтому мы так научены. Но сейчас уже мы понимаем, что и второе, и третье место, например, если мы занимали, то это очень достойный результат.
At that time we were taught that, you know, first place is really the only option. And now, as time and experience and age has taught us, first place, second place, third place, and every place at the Olympics is very valuable.
What are your memories of playing for Hall of Fame coach Николай Карпул?
Что ты помнишь, играть с Карпулом?
Сначала я думала, что очень трудно с ним играть, очень трудно работать. Но потом со временем я поняла, что это очень хороший человек, очень талантливый, очень умный, мудрый, который всегда поддерживает, старается сделать из тебя хорошего человека и игрока.
At the beginning, she thought it was very difficult to play for him. She was intimidated in many ways. But as time goes on, she understood how kind and how wise and how intelligent and how experienced and how he was loyal and supportive.
Благодаря ему я стала таким профессиональным игроком.
She thanks him very much for being this type of player.
So I mentioned earlier all of the different places you've played and the success you've had. What other coaches had a big impact on you?
Раньше он сказал, где вы играли, сколько страны, какие еще тренером был большой импакт на твоей жизни?
Все мои тренера, которые были в этих клубах, в которых я играла, они потом становились главными тренерами сборных команд. Поэтому я думаю, что каждый тренер оказал для меня тоже очень важную роль в моей карьере.
She thinks that all the coaches that she worked with, they both had a big impact on their lives, because all of the club coaches that she worked with became head coaches at their given or a national team. Mm-hmm. So after they worked and they won in the countries that she was with, they all became head coaches of a national team. And so in that sense, she thinks that her impact on them and their impact on her was very big.
I've spent some time going back over video in the last few weeks, and it's not hard for anyone to watch your highlights to recognize what an absolutely dominant attacker you were. When you look back at your playing days, how would you describe yourself as a player and a competitor, and what do you think your greatest strengths were?
как ты говоришь про сам себя, твоя самый сильный элемент в волейбол, ну, технический или социальный, в общем?
Ну, после работы в Японии я очень полюбила играть в защите.
After playing in Japan, she really learned to love playing defense.
Потому что в атаку я умела хорошо, как бы с самого детства атаковать, а
from
после этого больше полюбила защиту.
From a very young age, she was comfortable and enjoyed the attack, but after her time in Japan, where she spent a lot of years, she learned to love defense and other aspects of the game.
Let's talk about your competition. Who are some of the most impressive and challenging opponents that you had to go up against?
Кто самый крутой и трудный противник, с кем против играл?
Америка.
Америка. USA.
Потому что все очень хорошо организовано.
They were very well organized.
И очень трудно было с ними бороться.
They were very well organized. It was very difficult to fight against them.
So let's talk about the rules of the game. They changed significantly between 1992 in Barcelona, for example, and 2012 in London. What are some of your memories of going through rule changes as a player?
Ну, как волейбол менялся из 92 году Олимпийские игры до 12 году, как считает, все законом волейбол.
Ну, конечно, волейбол очень развивался с каждым годом, он все становился все лучше, интересней.
Every year, while she was playing, she
менялись
thought volleyball
правила.
Got more interesting, the rules, the changed.
Мячи, как бы мы не стояли на одном месте, а всегда что-то был какой-то прогресс.
There was constant progress and change in those years that she was playing. Это было лучше. She thinks it was for the better.
To be able to compete for as many years as you do, as you did, I have two questions. What was the key to your durability is the first question. What was the key physically to be able to play that long?
Какой ключевой ответ для так долго играет твое тело сохранить?
Здоровье, наверное, то, что меньше, чтобы травм, защитить себя от травм.
Как, он спрашивает, как это сделать?
Как соблюдать режим?
She was very disciplined in her regime and consistent.
And second part, did you have any significant injuries along the way that sidelined you for a period of time?
Большая травма был, который остановил тебя играть.
Спина и колени.
Her back and her knees.
So you traveled the world playing volleyball. What was your favorite spot? Did you have a favorite place?
Нет, каждая страна очень интересна по-своему.
No, every country is extremely interesting in its own right.
And was there one Olympic Games experience? It's exciting, obviously, to have been in all of those, but is there one particular games that, when you think back, that was your favorite for some reason?
Yes, самый любимый опыт олимпийских игр, один игр, кем ты помнишь?
Нет, потому что все равно на каждую олимпиаду свой возраст, свое понятие как бы приходит и.
Every time at the Olympic Games, I'm looking at it from a different perspective because I'm older, I have a different understanding of life. And so everything evolved as I got older and I evolved. My outlook
also changed.
Every game and every Olympics was different for me.
You have stayed involved in volleyball. Did you always expect to? Did you always expect that you would stay involved in volleyball once you were done playing?
Ты всегда думал, волейбол будет в твоей жизни? После ты играешь или играешь?
Нет, наверное, я так не думала. Просто так получилось, что мне нравилось, что я делаю, я продолжала играть, насколько я смогла.
I didn't think about it, and it just continued to happen, and I kept playing, and I kept being involved, and it just kept working out like that.
Может быть, я до сих пор бы еще играла.
She thinks, and she has said to me before that if she didn't have the kids, she never knows, she just could continue to play.
So can you talk to us about your volleyball factory? Together, you have developed this company, the Volleyball Factory. Talk to us a little bit about your goals with that.
Вместе мы сделали волейбольный завод, factory. Что ты думаешь об этом, как мы можем, что тебя желает?
Мы хотели поделиться своим опытом, своим умением с молодыми игроками, хотели передать им свой опыт.
We wanted to give them our experience and share it with the younger players and what we could give to them.
Да, я надеюсь, в будущем это будет продолжаться.
She hopes in the future that it will continue.
And speaking of the future, as you look ahead, what do you think is ahead for the sport? What are the next rules changes, or how do you think the sport will change, you know, in years to come?
Я думаю, что будет лучше и лучше это все развиваться. Больше людей будет заинтересовано в этом. Я думаю, что люди очень хорошо работают, очень хорошо рекламируют. Сейчас волейбол старается его больше развивать. Я думаю, что будет только интереснее это.
She thinks that a lot of people are contributing to volleyball and the numbers are growing, and she thinks that the future is bright, and she hopes that it continues like that, and she hopes that the support that everyone gives and everyone here that has been contributing to volleyball helps it to keep growing the way that she described that it was.
Finally, last question. How do you feel about being inducted into the International Volleyball Hall of Fame?
Как ты чувствуешь вот это?
Даже не знаю, как передать, но это большая вот, очень гордость, что люди, которые голосовали за меня, дали мне шанс быть здесь, что оценили мою работу.
She's not exactly sure how to describe it, but there's a great deal of pride and a great deal of appreciation for the people who voted for her and put her in here and recognized the years of hard work that she's put in and showed that type of appreciation by putting her in here, but the very few words describe the pride that she feels.
Не, потому что иногда думаешь, о, это я, а иногда думаешь, честно, это мне дали это.
Sometimes she says, okay, it's me, and then she kind of doubts, is it really me? Are you just putting me in here?
Well, we are indeed, and I want to thank you for your time. Sharing some of your story with us today and congratulate you for this great honor.
Спасибо.
Вам спасибо, что вы.
Thank you guys.
Mm-hmm.
Very much.
We have been speaking with International Volleyball Hall of Fame Class of 2018 honoree Evgenia Artemanova Essis. This is Volleyball in Perspective, and I'm your host, Joel Dehring. Thank you for watching.